morning, dear students. I hope you must have a wonderful summer vacation and you had enjoyed it to its fullest. But as we know that situations due to COVID-19 are getting worse and worse day by day, and online teaching is the only option left with us to continue the studies of our academic year 2020-21. So class, as you can see on board, today we are going to start the second poem of class 9, that is The Wind. This is the poem which is actually translated from Kannada version to English by poet Subramanya Bharti. The introduction of the poet. Subramanya Bharti is a poet who is known for his writings about nature. He used to write down poetry about nature, and he was very active in the form of as a poet and writer, as well as a freedom fighter before the independence of our country. Class, this poem is actually a translation from the Kannada version, as I told you earlier. The Kannada version of the poem, The Wind, was written by A.K. Ramanujam, who was a famous South Indian poet. Now class, let's go through the poem. The theme of the poem is, when the wind is under our control, or when it blows softly and at a steady rate, it is easy and we all enjoy the wind. But what happens when the wind gets out of control and it moves in a very unsteady and it blows off all the things around us? Let's read the poem. I'm reading the poem loudly for you all, and you all have to read the same poem again after this session, after this lecture. Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the window. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw down the books on the shelf. There, look what you did. You threw them all. You tore the pages of book. You brought rain again. You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings. Frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind, God winnows and crushes them all. He won't do what you tell him. So come, let's build strong homes. Let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body. Make the heart steadfast. Do this and the wind will be friend with us. The wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fire roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. So this is the poem written by Subramanya Bharti. Okay class, as you can see in the first four lines, the poet praises the wind. He says, when the wind comes softly, when it is very slow and steady, we enjoy it. It doesn't break the shutter of windows. It don't break our windows. It don't scatter the, it don't litter the paper here and there. It don't blow off the papers. It don't make the book from the bookshelf fall on the ground or on the floor. But there, you look what you have done. Now the poet is speaking to the wind. He says, see what you have done. Now you have gone out of control. Now you are not very soft. Now you are fast, heavy and unsteady. And after being heavy and unsteady, what you have done? You have torn the pages of the books which were settled nicely earlier. Now you have brought rain again and again. You have threw all the books from the bookshelf on floor. And after doing all this, you very cleverly make fun of the weaklings. Means the weakling here are the books, the papers and the pages of the books. Now, frail crumbling. Now the poet says, after the wind, heavy wind, what happens? Everything breaks off into small pieces. Everything blows off. He says the doors, the houses, the rafters, the woods, the bodies, all moves unsteadily here and there, and they all are hurt because of the strong wind. And he says, It is the God who had made the wind and who controls the wind. So we are no one, or we don't have enough power, we can say or order anything to the God. So the best thing for us to do is we must make our home strong. We must make our windows stand firmly against the strong winds. We should join the doors firmly, and we have to practice ourselves, or we have to make up our mind. We have to make up our mind to bear with the strong winds. He says, if we will do this, if we will practice of being habitual of the strong wind, and if we will complete our all the preparations by making strong walls, strong houses, making our the grills, window grills firmly stand against the strong wind, this way we can be friends with the wind, and this way it will not harm us. Instead of that, it will be acting like our own friend. And we know that the weak, when it is weak, it blows the weak fire. When the wind is under control, it blows fires. But when it gets strong, the same fire gets into a, or turns out into a forest fire, or it takes the dangerous avatar, right? And it's friendship. If we make the wind friend, it is good for us, because wind is something we need every day, and without wind we cannot survive. Okay class, this was the explanation of the poem. Now what you have to do in homework is you have to write down 10 words with their meanings in your fair notebook in a very beautiful way after writing down the name of the poem, and write the same way. But make sure you are working, or you are doing your work in a very neat and clean handwriting. Okay class, now it's the turn of extract based comprehensive check. See the lines. So come, let's build house, let's build strong homes, let's join the doors firmly, practice to firm the body, make the heart steadfast. Do this and the wind will be friend with us. So class, these four lines. So come, let's build strong homes, to do this and the wind will be friends with us. I'm writing down these lines on board. You have to read it carefully. Okay class, let's have a look at the board. So come, let's build strong homes, let's join the doors firmly, practice to firm the body, make the heart steadfast. So the first question is, why the poet says to join the doors firmly? The poet says to join the doors firmly to make or install the doors firmly so that it doesn't get blown off by strong winds. Second question, what is the meaning of make the heart steadfast? We have to keep our heart steady. We don't get disturbed because of high blowing winds or strong winds, but we should get habitual of strong winds, and instead of complaining, we should learn that, we should accept that this wind or strong wind can do this. We have to make ourselves habitual of this. The third question, what would be the result of doing all this? Is what will happen if we will join the doors firmly, to practice firm the body, or to make the heart steadfast? All these things will result, or will make the wind as a friend. All the thing, all these things will help us to be friend with the wind. Now, the fourth question, which words are the opposites of firmly? Firmly means something which is strongly holds itself. Firmly will be loosely. Second, steady is something which is of equal rate and pace. Unsteady. Fine. You have to write this. Okay, class. This is your homework. But before that, What you have to do, you have to write down, question number one is, write 10 word meanings in fair notebook. See class, what I expect from you all is, you would do this work in a very beautiful handwriting. So, this is it for today. Tomorrow we will discuss the question answers and another extract from the same poem in our lecture. That's it for today. Thank you and have a nice day.